Dear students, welcome to class 4, subject social studies. Name of the lesson, water resources. Look at the pictures below. Why do you think the child in the first picture is sad? What is making the child in the second picture happy? Can you notice? Yeah, it is the water which is making the child in the second picture happy. And in the first picture, the child is sad because there is no water. The land is very dry. So, why? Because we are learning this lesson to know that water is very, very important. Without water, there is no life. Sources of water. From where do we get water? Water is one of the most important things that human beings require to live. It is a very precious resource. We need water for drinking, cooking, bathing, washing clothes, and so on. Why is it called a precious resource? Because it is very, very important for life. Plants grow with water. Without water, plants will die. We will not get food if there are no plants. Yes? So, and without food, everybody will die. So, water is very, very precious. That means it is very, very important. Okay? The earth is known as the blue planet. Now, why is the earth known as a blue planet? Because from the outer space, if you see, the earth looks blue. Now, why does it look blue? Because 71% of its surface is covered with water. But only 2.8% is fresh water, which is fit to be consumed by humans. Consumed means what? We can drink it, okay, or we can use it, okay. The remaining 97.2% cannot be used by us directly as it is saline in nature. Now, what is the meaning of saline? The meaning is it contains salt. So, salty water cannot neither be used for growing the crops nor can we drink. So, 2.8% of water which is in the fresh form is used by all the human beings and animals and for cultivating the crops. Okay, so there are various sources of water. Some of these are given below. First one is rain. Okay, so rain is a form of fresh water. Rain is the main source of fresh water. So what is the main source of fresh water? It is rain. Next source of fresh water is groundwater. When rainfall occurs, some of the water seeps under the ground. You may have seen wells and hand pumps around you. These are dug to take out groundwater. For example, in your school ground, if it rains, yes, what happens after some time, you can see that the ground is filled with water. Yes, then the next day you come and see there is no water in the ground. Now, where has that water gone? It is all seeped inside the ground. Okay, it has gone under the ground. So, when the water is there under the ground, how will you take it out? You have to dig it up, okay, as wells. So, the water which is deep inside the ground, if you dig the ground, you will find the water there. So, that will come out in the form of, you can take it out in the form of wells and hand pumps, okay. You can bring out those water which is under the ground. Next, we will go to the next fresh water sources, that is rivers. Okay, rivers. The rivers are of the northern plains, as you have studied earlier, are perennial rivers and get water from rain and melting snow of the glaciers. They have water throughout the year. The perennial rivers get water from rain and usually dry up in some places during summers. Now, children, here, in this paragraph, they have given the peninsular. Here there is a printing mistake. It is not peninsular river. It is perennial river. Okay. Next source of water are ponds and lakes. So, these are also fresh water. Then we have seas and oceans. The water here is more in sea and ocean. But it cannot be used by human directly. Okay. Because it contains lot of salt. Water for irrigation. Okay, irrigation. Farmers in India mostly depend on rainfall for irrigating the fields. India gets rainfall during the monsoon season. But rainfall is not uniform. That means every time we don't get rain. Okay, it's not uniform throughout the country. For timely supply of water for the crops, the following means of irrigation are used. So India is a vast country. Throughout India, we don't get rainfall. Okay, few places we get rainfall and few places we do not get rainfall. So how people are using water for irrigation in different places, we are going to study here. Groundwater is brought to the surface through wells and tube wells, as you know. Okay, and this will be attached with the pumps. With the help of pumps, the water is brought out. It is most commonly used method for irrigation in North India. Okay. Ditches are dug in the fields to make water flow into the fields. Canals take the water from a river to the field. Tanks are reservoirs that store water to be mainly used for irrigation. This system is popular in South India. In the sprinkler irrigation method, water is sprayed in the field through pipes and sprinkling outlets. A dam is very big, strong wall built across a river to block and control the flow of water. Okay, water is stored behind the dam in a reservoir. Dams are known as multi-purpose projects because they are useful to us in many ways. Can you see there is a dam here? Yes. Now this is the dam at the back. Okay. So here the water is stored and later whenever the water is needed for irrigation, then they will open these windows. Once they open the windows, what happens? The water which is collected in the dam there in a big tank, that will flow outside. Again, when enough water is given to the fields, then they will close the reservoirs. Water is released out of the reservoir from a height to generate hydroelectricity. Hydro means water. Okay, so water and electricity produced by water is known as hydroelectricity. Dams are an effective measures against floods. They also provide water for irrigation. Water bodies are polluted by human activities such as dumping of waste, bathing, washing clothes in water. Factories often release their waste into the water bodies, thus contaminating them. Contaminating them means spoiling them, making it dirty. Water that is available for human use is scarce. Okay, that means it is very less and hence we must conserve it. Conserve it means we must save the water. We should not waste the water. Complete exercise A, B, C in textbook and exercise D in your classwork. Refer page 11.